Anytime you pray, and you pray in agreement with God's assignment for you, expect persecution. When you pray for relief, demons are happy, because that's a prayer the Most High will not answer. God will not answer relief-centered prayers. Why? Because the anointing is meant for you to be active in the here and now. The anointing is to assist you in doing the great assignment, which is to manage the earth so there's life and abundance for everyone in the here and now. That's assignment the Most High gave Adam and Eve, and that's assignment He gave to the apostles before He ascended to heaven. That's the same assignment we have today, formulated as go ye into the world and make all nations my disciples, and teach them to keep all that I've commanded you. And He said, be of good cheer, because I'll be with you till the end of the world. So Christ also told us to occupy till He comes, to do business till He comes. So we have a great assignment. All your prayers must be centered on that assignment. Any prayer that's not centered on that assignment will get the praise of demons. And demons will be happy to arrange things for you to get you your relief. But when you pray in agreement with Christ, expect persecution. I'm not telling you that your miracle is not coming. I'm not telling you that your breakthrough is not coming. It's coming, but it's a breakthrough. So there is a fierce resistance to keep you here and to break through it. So expect a fight. Too many of you, you just want things to unfold easily by itself. That's not how it goes with believers. And if you encounter a season in your life where things just unfold, just like that, without you having to do anything, ask yourself whether it's from God or not. Because likely that's not from God. Likely that's the enemy trapping you to later drag you to hell with him. Well, if you're a believer, God will drag you all the way to hell, but He can put you in an unfavorable, dangerous, and toxic situation so that others can get narcissistic supply at your expense. And Satan does this to drag those people to hell with him. So, as a believer, it's the norm that we will face resistance and retaliation when we walk by faith. It is. Anytime you trigger an outcome in reality that's not endorsed by common people will take offense. If common people expect you to be in poverty or expect you to be in sickness, and suddenly you manifest health and wealth, what's going to happen? They're now forced to look at themselves and to answer why they expected ruin on you. Oh, they expected ruin on you because they were looking down on you to feel good about themselves. So now that part of them is exposed and they don't want this. So when you manifest wealth and health, which goes against their narcissistic expectations, they'll experience a narcissistic injury, they'll feel hurt, and that will blame you for it. And when they can't undo the health and wealth you're operating in, they'll become homicidal towards you. And when that doesn't work out, they'll turn on each other. And because society doesn't want people to turn on each other, society will go after you directly when you manifest anything that's not in line with the status quo. So as a believer, understand that there will be persecution, there will be affliction, there will be resistance, there will be all of that. They'll be warring against you. Yes, they'll be warring against you when you walk in life and abundance. Let them war against you. Don't seek peace with them because they don't want any peace. They are at war against Christ, so they're at war at you. They want you to submit to their misery on their terms so they can have hold on you to feel relieved. They don't care how you feel, if you're happy or not, nor whether you're safe or healthy. It's all about them being relieved. Do you want peace with such people? The only way you can have quote-unquote peace with such people is if you allow them to victimize you and to vandalize you. And even then, they will still treat you in a... I'm saying this. If they're vandalizing you and victimizing you, they're treating you bad anyway. But even if you allow that to happen, they still will not be happy with you. So don't seek peace with this pathological world you're in. You're in the world, acknowledge how pathological the world is, but don't submit to it and don't agree with it. Agree with Christ. So expect retaliation, but I also expect you to overcome. Be at peace.